A lot of people want to have music wherever they go. Some download songs, some stream, and for those who like it old school, they tune into the radio. Hi guys, it's Michael from Samsung Developers. Today's episode is all about the Tizen FM Radio API. We chose the Radio API because it's really easy to learn and it can teach a lot about starting with Tizen. We'll give you an overview, a few requirements, and then show you how to use its code in a radio app we'll create later. Let's begin. The FM Radio API provides interfaces for accessing the FM radio. It's introduced in Tizen version 2.3 and provides the same functionality for both web and native apps. In our tutorial for today, we'll be using web apps to control the radio as the code is simpler to understand and follow. With the FM Radio API, you can control the playback of the radio by starting and stopping it. You can also scan for available FM stations. Lastly, you can get interruption information so your app can do extra commands when listening has been interrupted by a notification. This particular API is very sensitive with states, so we need to know what it can do at each state. Otherwise, we'll get state exceptions. The first state it is in is ready. This is reached when Tizen.radio is first called. From the ready state, you can start the radio, which puts it in the playing state. Inside the playing state, you can seek up or seek down. Seek up makes the radio search for the next higher available station, while seek down searches for the next lower station. To return the radio to the ready state, call the stop function. Back in the ready state, you can scan for all available stations by calling the scan start function. This takes the radio to the scanning state. While scanning, you can call scan stop to return the radio back into the ready state. Let's get a bit more technical. The FM radio object interface is implemented by Tizen. Inside the FM radio object is FM radio of type FM radio manager. The FM radio manager holds the bulk of all properties and methods of the FM radio API. This is where you'll find all the functions we saw in the radio states like start, stop, seek up, down, and many more. The FM radio scan callback interface provides methods when a frequency is found or when it finishes scanning. This is needed when you call the start scan function. The FM radio interrupt callback gives methods when an ongoing radio stream is interrupted by a more important phone service, like a phone call ring or a message notification. This is a parameter for the set FM radio interrupted listener of the FM radio manager. Lastly, the antenna change callback interface provides methods when a change in the antenna is detected, such as when it is attached or detached. This can be particularly useful when prompting the user to plug in their headphones to tune in. Let's get familiar with a few things we need to develop our app. For development, you'll need the Tizen IDE. As the radio API was introduced in 2.3, make sure that your IDE is also 2.3. If you don't have it yet, head on to developer.tizen.org and go to downloads. For testing, the emulator would do fine, but since our app uses the radio, it'll be more fun to have an actual device. If you don't have a device but still want to test it on the real deal, check out our remote test lab at developer.samsung.com. Time to learn the basics of using the radio API before we build our app. Starting the radio is simple. All we have to call is tizen.fmradio.start and pass a double value, which is the frequency we'd like to tune into. In our example, it's 99.7. Stopping is just as easy, simply by calling on tizen.fmradio.stop. To seek up or down, just call tizen.fmradio.seekup or seekdown. Optionally, you can add functions for the success and error callbacks to handle any errors. Remember that seekup or down is only available in the playing state. When scanning for stations, remember that the radio scan callback parameter is required, while the error callback is optional. In our example, we defined our radio scan callback to log the frequencies found in the console whenever it finds one. Afterwards, we called on scanStart, passing our radio scan callback as a parameter. Remember that scanStart can only be called in the ready state. Now that we know the basics of using the FM radio API, let's build an app to use it. Let's create a new Tizen web project. Under Mobile 2.3 Basic, just choose Basic Application and call our new project MyFM Radio. Our app only needs one page, so let's play around with index.html. Let's start with our app's first header and name it MyFM Radio. In our second header, let's call it a sample radio app. Since we don't really need the navigation bar, let's delete it. In our article's header, let's add an ID and call it current station to help us see what station we're currently on. Since we don't need an image here, let's replace it with text saying radio stop, tap listen. We also won't need this paragraph and list. Let's clear this paragraph section out to make room for our buttons and lists. Let's put a div here and a header to label it as controls. Under the header, let's go put our buttons for listening, seeking up, down, and scanning for stations. Don't forget to put the functions they'll be calling later when clicked. Let's leave a div here to see the radio status if any errors are found. We may also want to put controls so the users can jump directly to the station they want. For the number input, we added a step with a value 0.1. This lets Tizen know that the period should be made available for easier use. Lastly, let's go put an unordered list for our scan to populate with available stations later. That finishes up our UI. Now let's head to our JavaScript code in main.js. We added two global variables that our app will use from time to time, the frequency to play and the radio state. It's important to check the radio state before calling other functions so we get the current radio state, which we will place in an if statement for checking. If the state is ready, then we can call the start function and pass the frequency to play variable. With our radio playing, we should change the label of our button and name it stop. We should also change the header we named earlier as current station to show now playing. Since we are using the same button for stopping, we added an if statement to check if the radio is in the playing state. If it is indeed playing, the stop function will be called and we change the button and header back to their previous values. Now for the seek up function. Again, we need to check for the radio state, but this time, we only need to check if the radio is currently playing. If it is, we'll call the seek up function and pass the success callback and error callback. We'll define these later in the code. Do the same for the seek down function. Now for jumping to frequencies the user types in the page. We assign the frequency value from the user to the frequency to play variable. Then we update the current station header to display the new value. And call the start function to make the radio jump to the new frequency. As a bonus, we set the button to say stop in case the user presses the go button while the radio is in the ready state. The last major part of our app is scanning for frequencies. As always, make sure to check the radio state to prevent exceptions. The scan start function can only be called if the radio is ready. If it is, we first change the button to say stop scan. Then we define the radio scan callback to have two functions as defined earlier. The first one is onFrequencyFound, which passes a frequency parameter for every station found. Each time a station is found, we add it to the unordered list we created earlier by appending the frequency. This can help the user know which ones are available. As for unfinished, it passes an array named frequencies. In our example, we don't have much use for it as all available frequencies have already been displayed in a list. We just have to say that the scan is finished and change the button back to say scan. With our callback defined, we can now call scanStart and pass it as a parameter. Since our button also doubles as a stop button, we also check if the radio is currently scanning. If the user presses the button, the scanStop function is called and the button is renamed to scan again. Lastly, we need to define the success callback and error callback from earlier. For each successful callback, we display the text success callback. Since the frequency changed to a value we don't know, we should be able to know through tizen.fmradio.frequency. With the new frequency, we should update the display to show what station the user is currently tuned into. The error callback can accept a recent parameter which can show what went wrong. In our app, we just say that the following error has occurred followed by the error's name. Now let's build to see and hear it in action. When using our app, remember to plug in your headset to act as an antenna. If we tap on Listen, the radio plays the default station we set, which is 90.7. You'll also notice that the Listen button changed to Stop. If we tap Stop, the radio stops and the button changes back. For now, let's leave it turned on. Now let's try to seek up. As you can see, the station changes to the next available that's higher. Seeking down brings it back to the original station we were in. Let's try scanning for stations. The radio should first be stopped. We'll just tap the scan button and the radio starts scanning immediately. Each station it finds is displayed inside the list we made earlier. Now that we know what stations are available, let's jump to one of them. It's working great! So there's our functioning radio app for Tizen. It's really fun to make and test out. Let's have a quick summary on today's topic. The Tizen FM Radio API lets you build your own radio app. It was introduced in version 2.3 and includes support for both web and native apps. As you saw earlier, just a few lines are needed to get the radio started. The radio states are very important. For example, if you try to seek up or down while the radio is not playing, you will get a state exception. As a good practice, you should always check the radio state before starting, stopping, seeking, and scanning. Lastly, if you have no device, the Remote Test Lab is here to help you. Just head over to developer.samsung.com and click on Remote Test Lab. Thanks for tuning in to Tizen with the FM Radio API. We hope this gets you interested to play with the code. We can't wait to see your apps in the Tizen store. For more details on the FM Radio API, check out developer.tizen.org for tons of helpful material. If you have any questions, feel free to post them on developer.tizen.org and at developer.samsung.com. Please give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed our tutorial and subscribe to the Samsung Developers channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.